Hello, dear friends. My name is Arar Guliev, and we're in Sedlice, Poland. And today I'm very glad that I finally meet our friend Obed, who was the most persistent and goal-oriented client that we ever had. We're really glad that he made it through, that he's now in Poland, and we have a chance to talk to him more, talk to him now, and give him a chance to tell his story, how he came over here, and now is living and working in Poland. So, Obed, I'm really happy to see you here in Poland. It's a very nice early autumn, September. You've been here for a while. So you're already established here in Poland.
I really
want you to go back and tell us about the emotion you went through, maybe some hesitations, doubt, fears, and what was going through your mind?
Yeah, sure. Thank you so much, Aral, for yet having me again. This is my second video, I think, with you, and it's pretty much good. It is normal for anything that concerns money. If you're sending somebody money that you've never made, it's never easy. So it was so hard for me first. In fact, it took me quite some time to trust you with the money. It took me like 2 or 3 months for me to be able to pay up. So those are the first doubts, because you do not know the person that you're sending the money to, and you do not know anyone that has been through this same process. So you are basically not sure about anything, and this is hard-earned money. So you risk losing all of it if the company is not genuine. So that was the first fear that I had, and I remember not even telling my family about it, about what I was going to do.
Really?
Because if I told anybody what I was going to do, they would think that I'm insane. Like, really? You don't send money to somebody you do not know. So it's very, it was so sensitive for me that I had to just keep it to myself and believe the process. I just had my own faith, and I know that this thing is going to work. But it's not so easy, even for very many people. You'll always meet in the business like 10 or 20 clients that are all interested, but just one or two will take that leap of faith to be able to pay up the money. So the trust thing of, like, you don't know who you're sending the money to, it's really, really, really hard. In Africa, they would think you are insane if you tell somebody that you're sending them money for something that you can't behold. We are used to beholding physical things.
Yeah, absolutely. I understand what you're talking about. Majority of our clients are going through those fears.
Yeah, sure.
And what was the actual difficulties? Can you remember the situation, what was happening, how we helped you to overcome those?
Yeah, I think personally, I would give you credit for always being timely on communication on my side. That every time I had a question and I raised it to you, because I think I remember I asked you so many questions.
In the embassy?
Not in the embassy, before.
That's
when I said before a process. Before I made my payments and everything, I remember asking you so many questions. And for me, communication, the way you communicated was very key for me to be able to, to trust you with whatever I had to do. So I think your consistent and persistent communication and timely communication, I should say that it kind of erased most of my doubts, and I was, you know, ready to begin, irrespective of the other things I chose to, because I tried, of course, different agencies as well.
Yeah.
But I can see trend of communication and everything. I value professionalism, and that's something that I think I found attractive, that kind of cleared the doubts that I had to pay.
I understand.
Yeah.
And what was the practical difficulty? I remember you went through an appeal process.
Yeah, that's right. It is very hard. The documentation is never the end. Sending the money and the documentation is never the end. The hardest part again now comes to the path for applying for visa. Because most of us are like from Africa, and maybe even not just Africa, even Asians, you know, it's your first time and you're trying out these things. So you have no idea about how it goes and how the processes and everything. So, and of course we all know that just this documentation from Poland is not the only thing that gets you the visa, that even the side of you as an applicant, you need also some documents and you know, have to go to the embassy yourself. You have to prepare yourself for the interviews at the embassy. And I just want to thank you that you took me through most of the questions and what I expected. And I should pretty much say that by the time I went, you know, much as timid, but I was confident that at least, you know, I was confident that I had genuine papers, genuine documentation, and I knew that I would definitely get it. But it's never easy, you know.
I need to remark here that this is always what we do for everyone.
Yes.
So we really care about every single person who comes to us, and we try to help them out in the maximum way possible, and get the result that is similar to the one that you got.
Sure.
Another question: how do you enjoy life here in Poland? So anything was surprising or you found interesting, can you tell something about that?
I think the most interesting or most amazing thing, and also the hardest thing perhaps, is that the time that I came, because I came in times of deep winter when it was I think like -19 and it was snowing everywhere.
Freezing cold,
you know, everything was white. And
is that the first time you saw snow?
Much snow.
All right.
That much snow where everything is just, you know, everybody's flaked out. And it was very amazing for me, but at the same time, challenging, because it was very cold. But nevertheless, we came through. And also, I think right now, I should say that I hear so many complaints from different people and applicants that the salaries of Poland are not great. But also, the most amazing thing about Poland is that the cost of living, I just find it, because like, for example, I left Kenya and came here, and by the time I reached here, I didn't find all the difference between the lifestyle in Kenya, the cost of living in Kenya, and Shedulce, for example, is pretty much the same.
The
difference is very little, because with just about 100 euros or 150, you are able to, you know, walk through your months comfortably, which I find that amazing. Like in this beautiful city where we are today, houses, like your own accommodation, will go for around 150, 106. Like my first private room was 106 euros, yet I was paying much more than that in Kenya. So that's the most amazing thing for me, that much as the salaries are not that great, but then you are able to save something. And for me, that's what makes sense. As a young man trying to develop myself.
And what would you recommend to people who are just considering and, you know, weighing their options and thinking of applying and coming over? What would you recommend?
Just like any other investment, it needs personal responsibility.
Yeah.
Nobody can convince you about your investment. You should always be ready. You should always be ready to, you know, be responsible for what we're about to get into. So irrespective of the things that surround you or the beliefs, like in Africa, have different beliefs about certain things, but I don't think those should just withhold somebody from trying out.
Yeah.
So the guys that are trying to apply for this Polish visa thing, it works. It's genuine. It works. It might have some challenges, but trust me, you'll be happy if you finally go through. Because I trust Aral. He was my introduction to this place. And I thank God that I'm doing right fine here. So for everybody that is out there that is trying to apply for a work permit through Live and Study and through Aral, I am very confident that they'll be able to give you all the kind of technical advice that you need to make it through. Of course, coupled with also your personal effort, like I said, we need to be responsible. You know, he's not going to do everything for you. Even you as a person, make some research about some things, about the consulate and the life in Poland, such that, you know, it was going to boost your confidence.
Yeah.
It was going to make you feel like, you know, it will help you prepare even for the worst in Poland.
Yeah.
Because we know that Live and Study is not it's not the first and the last. When you get to Poland, when you get to Europe, there are a couple of other options and everything. So I just want to encourage you guys that are trying to, or that are in the process, that are about to make the decision on starting up with him, you are in the right hands, in the right place. I trust him. I trust Live and Study. I am sure that they'll give you the best of service that they can offer. So please be confident. Have some faith. Just like I had, it wasn't easy for me, but I made it through, even after being denied visa the first time, because there are certain things that I had wrong, like some recommendations that I'd put in my papers that are not very good. And that's the reason why the embassy denied me visa, and I know I had to go back and ask. I still came back to him and I asked him, so what's up? I didn't get the visa. What happens? He was able to give me the advice that I needed, and, you know, I put my papers right and I went for appeal. He gave me an appeal letter from Paul Metcon, and I went and appealed and I got the visa. Keep hustling. Keep up the battle. It's never easy, but I'm sure that once you persist, things will definitely get into place for you.
Excellent, excellent. Well said. It's very difficult for me to add anything else to what you said. You said it right. Thanks. I really appreciate your kind words. It feels very good to when your work is appreciated, and this is what we're trying to do here, to do the right thing for the people to reach to the place they want to get to.
Sure.
The last thing I want to add is for everyone who's willing to come over to work with us and be placed for work in Poland. It is important for them to understand that they're coming to work, and this is not leisure. Maybe first few days they're going to enjoy life, but then it's hard work. So if you're coming here, you got to be ready to be working, and that's the main thing that will be valued and will allow you to stay here and establish your life. So thanks for watching.